Hello, just we are about to start a discussion on the last topic of module 2, that is ergonomics. As we have already discussed in the earlier classes, the last class, I'll just briefly recall what we have studied. It was about design for X, or what we call as design for excellence, that is design for manufacture, design for assembly, design for quality, design for reliability, design for assembly, likewise. So just to recall you, it is one of the tool which is used in product design, wherein there are certain set of standards or guidelines for each distinct process which have to be followed or adhered during the course of product design, so that eventually at the end you need not make any modifications. So if while designing, if you strictly follow the design principles or guidelines for different operations, to some extent you will try to be avoiding unnecessary changes in the product which may have to be done if you are not following DFX. So to begin with the last topic, as already I have said, that product lifecycle itself has got a lot of important topics which they themselves form one separate subject. Similar to that, if you take the next factor, that is ergonomics, or it is called as human factor engineering, or it is the consideration of human factor while designing any product. So as you know that 100% more or less all the products have to be designed for better interaction with human beings. So whenever you design a product, you have to consider the human aspect. That is the logic. So you can see small advertisements which are appearing in newspaper. The automobile is ergonomically designed. The refrigerator is ergonomically designed. The chair is ergonomically designed. The bed is ergonomically designed. Tools are, see, ergonomics in general is taken from the Greek word. Ergo means work, nomos means law. So ergonomics study human capabilities in relationship to work demand. Whenever you have to execute any work, you have to see that the human is subjected to less fatigue, easier, better visual control. I can quote a lot of examples. You take the example of a simple automobile. In automobile, the components which come in contact with the human factor have to be designed. For example, the dashboard, it should be neatly placed. The steering should be comfortable for the driver. He should be in a better position to handle it. The gear knob should be designed perfectly. The brake pedal, accelerator pedal should be designed systematically. Depending on the height, depending on the personality of the driver, you can even adjust the what we call as the height of the chair or the visual controls. Display should be easy. You should come very clearly, it should be visible to him. What are the display? What is the speed? What is the fuel? What are the other various aspects? That all those things have to be very clearly studied. So this is a simple example of how ergonomics has to be designed. So now here for your syllabus, you should need not study in detail because it's a very small topic which is there in product design. So very briefly, you can just go through it. So now I think with this preliminary introduction, what I have said, you can come to know about the brief idea about what is ergonomics. Even you take example, your mobiles. The mobiles are developed such that the corners are not sharp, display is better. And why do you make the mobile light in weight? So that is easier for person to handle. So any product you take, it has to be ergonomically designed. Okay. So now there are certain laws of ergonomics. Again, as I said, no, there was earlier one separate subject that is called as work study. The name of the subject was work study. In work study, again, we have got time and motion study. In their work study, there we used to come about the small chapter that is ergonomics. In industry also, whenever you go for designing of plant layout, designing of the product, designing of your office, whatever is there, you have to see that it is easier for human beings to interact and interface. The simple mouse, what I'm handling while operating the cursor, that mouse also is ergonomically designed such way that when I hold the mouse, it gives me comfort. See how beautifully the left click is placed, right click is placed to make easy. They have got a small roller. See, you can type different type of mouse have been designed for ease of the operator. So when the product is newly developed, means they are making changes so that the product is more user friendly. That is the main concept. Earlier televisions to be very big CRT screen. Now they become sleek, small, like a slate. So they are developed better for better looks, better appearance, better handling. So ergonomics plays a very important role in the design of every product. So here in your syllabus, very briefly, you have to understand. So if I give the definition of ergonomics, it states that the scientific discipline concerned with undertaking of interaction among humans and other elements of a system and the profession that applies theory, principle, methods and data to design in order to optimize human well-being and overall system performance. So it's a very broad concept, keeping into various factors. The way you are doing the job, the way you are handling the product, the way you are doing the task. See, even small table corners, they are rounded. Why they are rounded? If the edges are sharp, then automatically what happens? The human beings are susceptible for injuries. The movement of the human beings in the plant are also made easy. See, if you want to design a small office for you, if you are sitting here, the printer is in another corner, the net connection is other corner, what will happen? You have to move about every time. So if you design a table in such a way, you sit in one place, you can operate the printer, scanner, net, all means without waste of time, you can access all these facilities with a better approach. So, whatever you design, you have to keep in mind the ergonomics. So, what happens by adopting strict principles of ergonomics? Increased productivity, because naturally, when the person can sit comfortable. See, you take example, let us take this further also, I will explain to you with the same example. A simple chair. Chair is simple, which is meant for seating. That is the purpose. But the objective is the chair which you have designed should be so comfortable that the person who is using it can sit for hours together. It looks very simple. Chair. What is the height of the chair? What should be the backrest? What should be the headrest? What should be the armrest? Whether it is adjustable, what should the material. So naturally, if the chair is designed well, you can sit for a longer time. When you sit for long, your productivity is improved, efficiency is improved, fatigue is not there, discomfort is not there. you feel happy to work, quality of work is improved, then your job satisfaction will be there. If the cabin is designed ergonomically with better air conditioner, humidifier, air purifier, if all facilities are given, then it means that your efficiency will increase. So when utilizing that product, the person should not feel inconvenient. Repetitive tasks should be avoided. Ease of handling should be done. So if that is done, then the customer is happy. So what is the definition of a product? A product that will satisfy the needs of the customer. So the product should satisfy the needs of the customer and keep him happy means that product should be ergonomically designed. So we can say there are three types of ergonomics. One is physical ergonomics, one is organizational ergonomics, one is cogenitive ergonomics. As physical ergonomics, it is more to do with the human body response, visual factor, body posture, anatomy of the human being is studied, what should be the height of the chair, what should be the backrest, what is his visual control, what is his area of operation that we call as a work volume, workload, repetitive strain, all these are considered in the physical ergonomics. Cognitive ergonomics deals with the mental process and capacity of human when at work. Mental strain from workload decision making human error and training fall at sea. See, naturally, when fatigue is there, repetitive work is done, the human mind is subjected to stress. That may lead to error. So, cognitive ergonomics deals with these capacity so that when a person is at work, all efforts have been made to see that his stress is greatly reduced. Now, organizational ergonomics, that's also very important. Most important, you might have studied about plant layout. Similarly, when the plant is layout is done, it has to design in such a way that there is a minimum travel of people. To do the work, see, even the small chambers, office, they are designed in such a way that the communication is done correctly. Teamwork is possible. So you are sitting in one corner, your boss is sitting in one corner, another person is in first floor, another person is second. So how can be communication done? Better visibility is not there. Supervision becomes difficult. You cannot cheer up. So the entire system, it is designed in such a way that the teamwork, the group activities will be given more of motivation. So these three type of economics you have to study. Physical ergonomics, that will deal only about the physical factors. Cognitive ergonomics, which deals with the aspect related to the mental stress. Organized effectiveness, that will help you to process the work environment in such a way that people feel they are like a family, they can communicate well, the boss can motivate all of you, and you feel that you are one unit. So that are the ergonomics which are adopted. So overall, the main motive of efficiency of what you call as the organizational economics is fatigue is reduced, speed of decision making, and physiological stress are reduced. So again, what happens is to maximize. See, human beings are what happens. They are, as you know, that you have to study the human body movement, or it is also called as musculoskeletal system. So it is nature that the body is designed for certain work. So how best you design a product that will help the body to feel comfortable? If you are stretching yourself, if your body is subjected to more strain while doing the work, then naturally what happens? The human body gets fatigued. As a result, efficiency decreases. Errors will creep in. Fatigue will lead to boredom. Whenever you switch on the machine, this is a very tedious machine. I have to operate that knob, this knob, this knob. So whenever you interact with the product, you should feel more comfortable. It should feel that, yes, this is an easy product to handle. Suppose you are using a CNC machine. the operator with his two hands, visual display, everything should be designed so that it will lead to minimum stress on the operator. If you give extra, he has to switch on, he has to go there, the display is on that side, the tool piece is on this side, then what happens? Automatically he will be bored, and then automatically it leads to his decreasing efficiency. So main objective is you have to study the human anatomy and design it for better movement. See, if you take an example of a simple chair, it looks very simple, but the chair where you are sitting is very, very important for people who sit in the chair and work for 8 hours. If that chair will create back pain, movement is easy, unable to talk, then what happens? It will lead him to the boredom, fatigue, errors. And when a person is tired, human body is tending to make errors, he will make mistakes. So the chair may look simple, but if the chair is ergonomically designed with better features like stretchable arms, adjustable arms, back stress, eye adjustable height, better foam material, leather, then hydraulic rising, auto adjustable vibrators will be there in some chairs, backrest should be good. So when you design a chair, you have to keep all these factors into consideration. See, this is the components of the chair: rotating wheel, seat, backrest, headrest, how the armrest should be designed, adjustable headrest should be of what material, what should be the shape of that headrest which will help us to rest our head when you are sitting on the chair, movement by giving a rotating wheel, how the arm should be there, all these. If you want to make an adjustment, it should be easy for you. So simple design is given, how stepwise each and every aspect is observed, and then the product is ergonomically designed. These are all the various parts you can see in detail. You'll come to know how they are designed. See, this is a final view. How the base is designed, adjust. See, whenever you see knobs, are the knob, what is the shape of the knob? Most of the knobs are spherical. Why are they not in the form of square? Because sharp edges. If it is in the form of a knob, you can operate easily. Seat depth, seat stool. What material? If you are using leather, of course cost increases, but it has got certain advantages. Artificial foam, wood chair is better. So compatible material, headrest, backrest, all these has to be. Even to some extent, you can even design a footrest. Same way, you can take an example of a big crane. The crane is very big. There is only one operator. That operator has to design the jib crane, you can see here. He is sitting in a small cabin. If all the controls are positioned in a very position, he cannot get up and go and operate it from backside, top, no. All the controls should be placed and it should be well within his reach. He should sit in the chamber of that jib crane and then with his left hand, right hand, see, that also positioning is important. Those gears, levers, which require more strength, they are positioned on the right, because generally, if a person is right-handed, the right hand can exert more load. If those buttons which require less force, they can be positioned on the left side. Important view should be there present on the front of the driver so that he can take a decision. Big arms while he's moving on the jib crane, that arm will not collide with the surface. If controls are not properly, the operator finds difficulty in handling the crane. When he finds difficulty in handling the crane, naturally it will be tedious for him. And if the controls are not positioned properly, then there are chances that he may come with some accidents. You see the cockpit of an aircraft, how it is designed. There is a pilot, co-pilot, how all the displays are there. What are the displays in the aircraft? What is the height? What is the fuel? Number of engine working? Lot of displays will be there. all those displays should be mounted right in front of the what you call as the pilot, so that all controls are easily visible. You can control the plane, you can actuate the landing, all operations can be easy. If the controls are not properly displayed, one in that corner, other in that corner, then it will be tedious, and that will lead to the wrong decision and eventually may lead to the failure of the craft design. So now, by discussing all these points, you might be realizing the importance of ergonomics. So this is the last topic of what we call as second module, and some portions of third module, that is product development, also we have covered. Again, I'll take up the third module in detail when we start the product development. Okay, so just to recall what all the things you need to study in this second module. First is product design, engineering design, product development. What is the difference between product development and product design? What are the basic processes of product development? What are the basic steps in product design? How the design, product design can be improved by using latest tools in the form of CAD/CAM, by using latest methodologies like concurrent engineering, also called as simultaneous engineering, and DFX, that is design for X, that is X stands for excellence, design for assembly, design for manufacture, design for quality, etc. Then we have to study about what are the stages, what are the strategies, not the stages, strategies to deal with the end of the product. So when the product is no longer in use, how it can be reused, reconditioned, dismantled, reconditioned. And also one more thing I want, you should know about what is organization and decomposition. Decomposition also is a new term to you. It means that splitting the work into different parts. So that all these things, and including the last factor, that is human factors in product design. All these things I have possibly tried to cover in this PPT, which I have already shared with you. And along with what I have shared with you, the notes also, I have some material I have collected, which is possible. That notes is in the PDF format, which I will upload to your WhatsApp, that you can share. And once you feel, go through the notes, PPT, discussion, and any other material which is available to you from various sources, then you can probably go and then try to attempt assignment number 2, which I will be shortly giving you to you. So most of the assignments have been submitted. First assignment is submitted by all the students. So those are not submitted, please make it a point to submit. As already you know, because these are changing scenario, it is even new for us. For the first time, we are taking online courses, which slowly we are trying to update ourselves. Maybe at first instance, it is not possible. But slowly and steadily, I feel that as we proceed, things will improve. So as much as possible, we should try to cover the syllabus. And there are some subjects where it might be difficult to rely on online courses. But then still, you need not subject like PLM. There is very much possibility that you can very easily attempt and you can solve them. So if you have any doubts, you can communicate to me through your mail. And because having online courses rather than offline is better, we'll see in the due course, we'll again try to arrange some online course where you can interact with me in a better way and you can ask some doubts. So go through the entire presentation of these, what you call as classes, which I have gone through. These are all things which I don't think will be much of difficulty for you to go through, because these are all things which you have learned. There are some new words like concurrent engineering, DFX, decomposition, product process, product. All these things you can go through and you can set some new examples. And once you feel confident, you can try to solve the assignment problems. So, and you can go to the third module, that is product development, which already some phases we have covered here, but then too, we will take it separately and try to solve. Okay. So, thank you.